Today I'll be showing how to use or move an Autel AP200 dongle to a second device. There's been a lot of misconception that the AP200 is totally bound to the first device that is registered to, and if that device dies, so does your AP200. But let's dive in together as I move my AP200 to a new phone that I just got. Now let's get this. This misconception generally comes from the binding process that you have to do when you first register the AP200, but that binding is to your Autel ID or account and not to the phone or the tablet. So even this Amazon comment from supposed Autel support isn't correct. On the right, I have the old phone that I registered the AP200 to, and on the left is the new phone that I just got. To demonstrate, if I click on the Autel app on the old phone, you can see that the Honda and generic OBD softwares are both free for as long as I have the AP200, and that's marked by this infinity icon that you can see down here. The way the AP200 works is that Autel gives you one free car brand for a lifetime, and you also get generic access to all vehicles through the EOBD app. If you want to get another vehicle software, you have to pay $21.99 every year for that. I did a detailed video on the AP200, which you may watch after this one, just in case you need more details on the device. I've already downloaded the AP200 app on the new phone, and opening that, I'm asked to log into my Autel account. I enter my credentials and log in. Now, the first thing you want to do is to click on the more icon that you have on the bottom row. I chose Honda as my lifetime access software. You can see that it's available for free for me to download to this device. I click on download and that starts. And while it runs, I also search for the generic OBD app and initiate the download as well. Heading back to the Honda download, and you can see that it's completed and it's unzipping and installing the file. That installs. I back out of there and click on diagnostics. Both softwares are now available for use. To move forward, I disable Bluetooth on the old phone so that the Autel app on the new phone can pair with the AP200 dongle. I click on VCI and initiate pairing with the dongle. And once that completes, it moves us back to the diagnosis tab, where I select the Honda app, click on automatic selection. It decodes the VIN, and I go through the usual communication steps on any Autel or scanner device, and then initiate a full system scan. And as you can see, the full system scan continues, showing that this new phone is now paired to the AP200 scanner. Also, if I disconnect Bluetooth on the new device, I'm able to still connect the AP200 to the old device, meaning that you can actually use the AP200 on multiple devices. Watch out for my upcoming review of a number of Bluetooth dongles from X-Tool. Just in case you are in the market and trying to make a decision on which dongle to buy, you may want to watch the video next week as you consider and finalize on your choice. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.